day of Matt's Automotive Adventures. We're in Sand Hollow. Try something a little bit different today. Gonna try a voiceover on this video. See, you guys will hear me chime in once in a while. At this point in time, the suspension was getting very creaky on the Jeep. It had a rough go of 5 days in a row wheeling in Moab. Particular place in mind. We're kind of just freestyling this, exploring the desert. Honestly, I have no idea what trail we're on. We're just crawling along and seeing what we can find. Over there is Sand Hollow State Park. Water looks beautiful. We went by that this morning. We went through the tunnel and now we're exploring what's on this side of the highway. I can't believe I did this.
Guy's in two-wheel drive.
What a guy. bombing down the sand dunes, the Jeep is perfectly fine. But as you're about to see, this is where the Jeep started to see its limitations. This is where you need high horsepower and wheel speed. So the complete opposite of what my Jeep was built to do. Up until this point, the Jeep did great and did awesome in Moab. Had no problem climbing everything that we threw at it. But as soon as we get some loose sand, I just didn't have the power in the higher gears to get the wheel speed that I needed, so I had to keep it in a lower gear, and this is what we had. Sand is definitely a learning experience. So this was the solution. Just give it all I could to get up the sand dunes. That poor little TDI is screaming. So as we were just driving along, we came across Double Sammy, as you're about to see here. And we decided to do just a little bit of it. Once we got up this portion here, I saw what I thought was top of the world. So we decided to start driving towards that. And it was top of the world, and we actually made it out there, so that was pretty cool. I decided doing Double Sammy completely by myself was probably not a good idea, so we just did the way in, the way out, and carried on with our day. It was starting to get very hot by this point, so neither one of us wanted to break down. Oh man, that creaking. It doesn't creak anymore, so I don't know if it was just dry or something, but the creaking's gone away. I can't get to do it now that we're back home. I can't find anything that was loose, so yay for self-healing problems, but it would have been nice to know what that was. There goes the bumper again. Some of the only wildlife we saw. So right around here is where we saw what we thought was top of the world. So we just started heading in that general direction and it actually took us there. Found a little like pond, or maybe you could call it an oasis. I really did enjoy this. Just street signs in the middle of the desert. That was actually pretty cool. The camera doesn't do the scenery justice. It really doesn't. And here we are bombing across the desert. Jeep did all right for saying it's short arm suspension. Did all right bombing across the desert. And here we are at top of the world in Hurricane, Utah. It was very busy up there, that's why I didn't film anything. I just got a picture of the Jeep. So after we looked around, took our picture, we decided to head on down and see what else we could find. More desert street signs. Well, we were out taking some pictures of some cactuses because there's some pretty cool looking ones out here. This is the amount of trash that we found and picked up, and we're going to take it to the appropriate garbage can. This one's actually pretty old. Look at the toes on you. A lot of the lizards out there were pretty chill. Thanks for letting us get a close up, little guy. And here's some of those cactuses. Again, thank you guys very much for watching. I appreciate it. This is the end of our wheeling portion of our trip. The rest of it we spent hanging out with some friends. And can't wait to do it again.